everybody. I'm Suha Tayyeb, Mededia intern.
So in today's video, we will be covering standard deviation, variance, and skewness. Let's begin with standard deviation. Standard deviation tells us how close values in a data set are to the mean. So if you're going to look at this curve on the right side, we have the x-axis whereon we have plotted our mean denoted by mu and standard deviation on either side denoted by sigma. On the y-axis, we have the population density and we will be plotting our values along the mean, right? So if we have a low standard deviation, this indicates that the values tend to be close to the mean of the set. So our curve would look something like this. Notice the shape of the curve and the values plotted on the x-axis. You see the curve is elongated, is dense, and concentrated around the mean. But when we have a high standard deviation, this would indicate that the values are spread out over a wider range. So our curve would look something like this. Now, you see how the curve is flattened out and our values on the x-axis have spaced out. Here, we're going to be taking a little example. So we have class A and B scores, and we will find out its mean, and you'd see that the mean of class A is 50. And when we calculate standard deviation, this is 25.8. So when we'll plot a curve on the graph, the curve would look something like this. But when we talk about class B scores, its mean, although is the same, we would expect we would have a similar curve, but our standard deviation is 5.6 and it is pretty low. And that would mean that our values are going to be concentrated around the mean. So this simply highlights the importance of standard deviation is that we can have data sets with similar means, but the standard deviations would be really different. And this is a really simple data and we can look at it and tell how spread out it'd be, because look at the class A scores, how well spaced out they are. And they lie within 10 to 90 range, but class B scores are more concentrated within 40 to 60 range and don't have a similar interval. So that is how. Now we talk about variance. So variance measures variability from the average or mean and is denoted by sigma squared. If you remember that standard deviation is denoted by sigma and variance is denoted by sigma squared, you could easily figure out the relation between the two. Now it's calculated as the average squared deviation of each number from the mean of a data set. Here's a little relation between standard deviation and variance. Variance weighs outliers more heavily than data very near the mean due to the square, and a higher variance helps you spot that more easily. So this is what the formula of variance and standard deviation look like. To simplify, variance is equal to the square of standard deviation. What this slide simply means is that if we take the similar example of classes A and B, and we saw what the standard deviations were, and if we were to calculate our variance, which would be square of standard deviation, so class A variance would be 666. And our curve looks something like that. But class B variance would be 32. So what we're trying to say is that although in this example, our standard deviations have a huge gap between them, we can easily spot the difference, but we're in data that have a very small or a closely related standard deviation values, how we can distinguish between the two data sets would be calculating the variance, because we will be squaring our standard deviation values and that would give us a bigger number. And when we plot it on our graph, it would easily spot the outlier. Now we talk about skewness of curve. So we have a negatively skewed curve and a positively skewed curve. How do we tell which one's which? Let's simplify it. Here we'll take Tom and Jerry, everyone's favorite, a classic, and we're going to take Jerry as an example. So notice the direction of Jerry's tail. So if we were to see a curve with a tail extending towards the right side or the positive quadrant, this would be a positively skewed curve. And if we were to see Jerry's tail pointing towards the left side, or our curve tailing towards the left side, that would be a negatively skewed curve. And so that was about that. Now we're going to calculate all that we've done so far using sample data in Excel, because Excel makes our life that much easier. But before we get there, here's what Excel looks like. So Excel is a spreadsheet software with rows and columns. So we can arrange our data, and our columns are labeled with alphabets and rows are labeled with numbers. And each box in here is called a cell, and each cell has a reference, cell name, cell reference, or cell number. And that's really important in terms of using our formulas, because formulas in Excel require cell names rather than the values within the cell. Also, another thing to remember is that formulas in Excel begin with an equal to sign. All right, so here is a data sample, and we will use the heights column to calculate our mean, standard deviation, variance, and skewness. Let's begin with mean. You're going to type in equal to average, because mean is the average of a data set. Open your parenthesis, select your data range, close your parenthesis, press enter. That's your mean. Standard deviation is calculated similarly. Start with equal to, write in STDEV, open bracket, close parenthesis, select your data range, close the parenthesis, press enter. Standard deviation is 9.85. We will round it to two decimal place in a bit. Variance, really simple. Let's start with equal to, type in VA, VAR, open parenthesis, select your data range again, and close the parenthesis, press enter. So variance is 97. Now we can also calculate skewness and see if this data would give us a positively skewed curve or a negatively skewed curve. Equal to, type in skew, open parenthesis, select your data range, close parenthesis, press enter. So 0.4, it's a positive 0.4, that means our curve is going to be positively skewed.
Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to comment below any questions.